begin tonight at 10 with a disturbing, deadly attack. A homeless man now behind bars for murder. This after a Denver man was found beaten to death just steps away from his own home last week.
And only on Fox 31, we're speaking with the victim's roommate, who thankfully was not home during that alleged burglary. Our Talya Cunningham joining us in studio tonight with that exclusive interview. Talya.
Yeah, guys, this is just very disturbing. It was a brutal and violent crime that's really shaken up our community. Take a look here. This is Jonathan Douglas, who friends affectionately call JD. He's 34 years old, a local bartender who worked late nights, but last week, he never made it home.
I don't know.
At a loss for words, Michelle Glancy is emotional, still trying to process that her roommate and friend was murdered.
We're all just gonna miss him.
Jonathan Douglas, known as JD, loved to bartend. That's how he and Glancy met, now living together for the past 5 years.
He was really kind. He had a huge heart.
The 34-year-old was killed just steps away from his home on North Mariposa Street near La Alma Park on April 17th, dying of blunt force trauma. According to court records, paramedics uncovered an unknown male lying face down on the ground with a pool of blood under his head, covered in a blue tarp with facial fractures and lacerations, and his pockets were turned inside out. Tonight, this man, 33-year-old Stig Strong, is behind bars, charged with murder, robbery, and burglary. Surveillance video shows a man walking up and down the street, checking car doors and walking in people's yards, who appears to be carrying a flashlight. Some type of confrontation happened between the suspect and victim, likely for being on JD's property.
I don't know why he was, like, even on our lawn.
Then video shows the suspect leaning over the bartender on the sidewalk. Police could not find JD's cell phone or keys and tracked his phone, leading him here to 13th and Santa Fe, where Strong was taken into custody. Court records state Strong confessed to punching him twice, but then changed his story multiple times.
I don't spend the night there. I don't feel safe.
Thankfully, Glancy was not home at the time, but authorities believe Strong used JD's keys to enter and stole her laptop, jewelry, and some cash.
Just an awful story. Now, the bartending and restaurant communities have really come together to support JD. Take a look here. In just 6 days, over $10,000 has been raised on this GoFundMe, and other events are planned in the very near future. As far as the suspect is concerned, Strong, he's expected in court on Friday. In studio, Talya Cunningham, Fox 31. All right.